Hello and welcome to the second annual Navajo Award Show, hosted by your very own NES News team. We here at NES News are ecstatic that you're joining us again this year, aren't we, Henry?
Yes, we absolutely are. Navajo Awards Day is such a special day. It's a day to recognize friends and classmates for their hard work and accomplishments throughout the whole year. I'm definitely excited for it, and everyone else should be.
Me too. I'm especially excited and anxious to get to the end of the show.
The end? We barely even started, and you want it to be over already? We're not that bad. Sheesh.
No, I don't mean I want it to be over. I just can't wait to get to our final two highly anticipated awards, the Citizenship Award and the Very Special SOAR Award. Only one fifth grade student earns that award.
You know, that's right. But before we can get to the end, we've got to start at the beginning. And look at all these fabulous people out here today. Are you guys ready?
Good then. To help us out today, we have our team ready and waiting. Our NES and our NES correspondents are out there somewhere. I know you're out there. Molly, is that you?
Alexa, this crowd is pumped today, and I'm pumped to present the first award to a group coming off of some amazing performances just a couple weeks ago. Justin Timberlake has nothing on these musicians. Of course, I'm talking about the Navajo bands conducted by the awesome Mr. Everson. First, the Junior Eagle Band. Coming to Navajo presents the opportunity to participate in band for the first time. The fourth grade Junior Eagle Band performs at the Navajo Fine Arts Night in the winter, as well as the District 128 Band Concert in the spring. The band rehearses once a week after school in small groups, and once a week after school in the full assemble. And now here is Miss Adam Mose with this year's recipients. Next, the Eagle Band. The Navajo Eagle Band is our fifth grade band. This group meets as a full band after school on Mondays, and they meet during the school day once a week for sectionals. This group also performs at the Navajo Fine Arts Night as well in the winter, as well as the District 128 Band Concert in the spring. And the recipients are...
Thanks, Mrs. Anamonis and Molly, and congrats to all the band and members. Hey, Alexa, speaking of music, do you know where the music teacher left his keys?
No, not at all.
On the piano, get it? Because the keys and is on the piano.
Yeah, oh boy. Let's throw it over to Georgia.
Thanks, guys. Georgia here, and this group is definitely excited for this next award. The next group of students made it their goal to find ways to help those in need. With the help from Mrs. Ryan, they really showed that kindness counts and that no act of kindness, no matter how small, is ever wasted. The Community Service Club began the year by collecting box tops for education. The money from the box tops helps buy various items for the school year. Next, the club collected items to donate to PAWS. We received many toys, towels, and cleaning supplies. Additionally, the Community Service Club collected coats, mittens, and scarves for families in need. These items were donated to the Worth Township. The Community Service Club kept very busy this spring with our annual Pasta for Pennies drive. Navajo School collected over $2,000 for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Lastly, the club collected food for the local food pantry. Donations totaled to over 125 pounds of food. Thanks for all of your hard work. Mrs. Adamonis, the recipients, please.
We're going to soar with kindness. Kira's here, and the excitement in this room is truly contagious. As I get ready to present this next award, I'm thinking about my shopping list. You guessed it, next up is the award for school store, sponsored by the fantastic Miss Castellana. The Navajo school store is managed by the 5th grade students. The store is open on Fridays from 8 to 8:10. The students choose a variety of school supplies, act as sales clerks, and give correct change to their customers. All profits are used to pay for end of the year activities. Congrats to the following recipients, Ms. Anamonis.
La 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 la. Oh, hi. Just warming up for this next award. This Eagle Award is for some true songwriters. The Navajo Chorus, directed by the wonderful Miss Miller, consists of 24 fourth and fifth graders. This dedicated chorus rehearses on Thursday mornings before school. They performed at a fine arts night, their choir concert in May, and step-up day. They learned how to sing two-part canons as well as three-part canons, which is pretty impressive for fourth and fifth grade. Thank you to our chorus singers for their hard work and dedication. Miss Inamonis, who are our recipients.
Thanks, ladies. You Eagles are really rocking it. Way to soar.
I agree. These Eagles are flying so high. Maybe we should have a SOAR award, one that we give out to one student who really shows what it means to soar.
We do. Remember, it's called the SOAR award, but you have to wait until the end for that special award. Maybe we should throw it to Peter to help us out with this next award. Hey, Peter!
Catch!
Touchdown! Someone called a pitch because that was a great catch. Oh, and the next group of Eagles had a great time during intramurals, games, friends, and fun with Miss Holman and Miss Sisters. This year, intramurals worked on sportsmanship, strategy, and having fun. They played a variety of activities, including basketball, flickerball, ultimate frisbee, kickball, and more. And the recipients are...
Thanks, Peter. Hey, it's Carson, and this next award has me thinking about my needs over wants. You know, supply and demand? It's economics. Well, maybe we can ask our next group of Eagles about it, and the economics poster happens. Students study an economic concept and create a visual depiction of the chosen concept to demonstrate their understanding. Entries are judged on originality, creativity, and accuracy of concept. Miss Anamonis, who are this year's recipients?
Amazing job!
Yes, well done.
What are you doing?
Just trying to calculate how much time we have left until the SOAR Award.
Well, how about we send it over to Eamon, who has a group who has done some calculating of their own.
The next award recognizes those students had to do some serious calculating. When they participate in the Math Bowl, students meet for 8 weeks, practice mental math, problem solving, and logic puzzles. They work together as teammates to help make each other stronger mathematicians. Miss Anamonis, the participants, please.
Great job, math bowlers and coaches. Hey guys, I am Abby, and this side of the room is getting anxious for the SOAR Award and Citizenship Award. But first, I have some serious students to present this next award to. The students are scientists in the making, maybe even the next Albert Einstein, or better yet, Marie Curie. AAUW hosts a STEM Day at Marine Valley Community College. STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math. It is open to all fifth grade girls in the South Suburban Chicago area. Girls attend to an overview from women successfully in STEM fields and attend 3 breakout sessions where these women provide hands-on activities that resemble those they do every day. Now, this year's participants are...
Or not. That is the question. But what isn't the question is how awesome these next Eagles are. They may not be William Shakespeare yet, but they are young authors. For young authors, students submitted writing to the Letters About Literature contest, the American Association of University Women's History Month essay contest, and poetry to present at the District 128 Board of Education meeting. The LAL requires students to think about the book they have read and how it has a strong impact on him or her. Then write a letter to the author thanking them. The AAUW essay contest is for 5th and 6th graders only. Students think about a woman who has witnessed or been involved in a historical event. This event must have changed a woman's life in some way. The student researches the event, prepares a series of oral interview questions, then conducts an interview with the selected woman. They write an essay explaining the event and its impact on their interview. Students wrote poems to celebrate March and April Madness, Poetry Month. They read mentor texts and used them as models for their own writing. Eventually, all the writing became even more creative and original. They presented at the District 128 Board of Education meeting on Wednesday, May 8th, 2019. Congratulations to the following recipients. Bravo, bravo.
It's hard to top that, Kayla, but let's try with our next award, because these next students sure so love to read, so much that they completed the 40 Book Challenge. The 40 Book Challenge challenges all students not to only read at least 40 books by the end of the year, but is also a variety of genres. Mrs. Edamonis, who are this year's bookworms?
You eagles certainly know how to impress.
They sure do. Hey Alexa, do you know what time it is?
I sure do.
I'm so excited!
Me too. I can't wait for this next award. It's definitely a fan favorite. I don't want to brag or anything, but it's a good one.
It's not bragging if it's the truth. Let's let Danny present the best, next award.
Thanks, guys. I am pleased to present this very prestigious award to the future of news media and the one and only NES News Team and their amazing, incredible club sponsors, Mrs. Degnan and Mrs. Darnan. It is because of all of them that we get this wonderful program today. NES News is a media club where students report on current happenings at Navajo, in the district, and local weather and sports. Students brainstorm topics, write ideas, reports, record, and help edit the final cuts. Ms. Edamonis, would you please tell us who the NES News recipients are?
Guys, please hold your applause. Please, this is too much.
Henry, no one's clapping. They stopped a long time ago.
Right. Well, thanks anyway.
Hey, is that money on the floor?
Ooh, money! It's just a penny. But I bet Kayla knows a group of eagles who would know how to make that penny grow into a whole lot more.
You do, Henry, because these students know that money doesn't grow on trees, but in the market, the stock market. The stock market club really shows you the money. Students were given a total of $100,000 to invest in companies of their choice with the goal of even making more money. After learning a little bit of stock market lingo, they had to research, collect, and record data and compromise with their teammates to make choices that would either ultimately help them earn money or lose it. Miss Edamonis, who are these year's participants?
Henry, it's time!
Yes, the moment we've been waiting for!
Let's check in with a few of our NES team members and see how the crowd is doing. Kira, how's everyone out there?
Seats, guys. The crowd is really anxious to hear who will win. Peter, how about where you are?
Absolutely, Kira. We're all anxious and excited and ready to cheer on whoever wins. Bridget, what's it like by you?
Same, guys. It's intense over here. I don't think we can wait much longer.
No, you guys don't have to wait. The Citizenship Award is first.
Navajo Citizenship Award is presented to two students from each classroom who exemplify leadership in the classroom, both academically and socially. This award honors these students who have shown their words and actions that they possess the qualities and characteristics we hope to instill in all our students at Navajo. These students participate in school activities, show a positive attitude towards classmates, school, and the community, and possess a strength of character and the courage to do what is right. Ms. Edamonis, please invite up this year's recipients.
Eagles, you all should be proud of yourselves.
Guys, it's time. The Navajo Eagle Soar Award is the most prestigious award.
It certainly is, Alexa. It's a pretty big deal. And whichever fifth grade aider receives it should be really proud of themselves. We know we are.
I agree. This award is given to one outstanding fifth grader in recognition of academic achievement, citizenship, and school spirit displayed during their time at Navajo School. This student is chosen by vote of the staff members at Navajo School. This student must be daily in his or her life. Show respect towards other students and staff, do well in academics, maintaining a highest grade point in average, be an example of kindness, responsibility, and possess a positive attitude towards school and learning. The teachers, administration, and staff of Navajo School are pleased to announce our 2018-2019 recipient of the Navajo Eagle Soar Award.
Drum roll, please. Mrs. Edamonis.
We're
so proud of you. Way to soar.
Sadly, this brings us to the end of our program. We'd like to thank all of our NES News team members, both on and off camera, for their help in bringing you this year's show.
Thank you, Mrs. Kutris, for organizing all the awards, and thank you to Ms. Animotis for presenting all of the students and with their certificates.
Thank you to all of our teachers for supporting the various clubs and programs that allow us to soar all year. And thank you to all of our parents for being here today and every day. I'm Alexa.
And I'm Henry.
Stay classy, Navajo!
In my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights, when everything goes nowhere to hide, when I'm getting you close, when we move, well you already know. So just imagine. But you when you